everybody. This is Hector Mendoza from Muscle Development Online. I'm here with the legendary, one and only, Silvio Samuel. It's a great honor to be here.
It's a pleasure, brother.
And I'm humbled right now to be able to be here. I mean, when I saw you come in earlier, I was like, wow. But tell me, last time I saw you was around 2009, and you decided to jump in the 212 class instead of the open. Give me a little bit of information about this. What was the change to go from open to 212?
Yeah, you know, it's a decision that I have to make after staying 8 years without competing. So coming back now, I kind of feel it's not the way I have to come in with the size, trying to, you know, fight the size game with the big boys. So I have been there, I know what to do. So I decided to just start from the low in order to bring the quality of muscle and then build up the size that I have to build so I can get a very good condition. So that's the reason why I have to do this and then go gradually from here to see what I can pick up by next year.
Gotcha. Do you have any plans on any further shows after this?
Actually, I do, because after having this break now, so I come in down to, you know, be taking part in the shows that I have to. The difference will be, it's not that I'm going to do like 8 or 9 shows like it happened 2007, 2008. I'm just going to pick a very few one at the moment, like 3 or 4. Then I look at how my preparation and competition goes based on the qualification also that I could have. For the Olympia, then I can take a break and then know I got some time to prepare for Mr. Olympia. Yeah.
Hey man, good to hear that. So what do you think about the changes that you've seen between the eight-year period? What changes have you seen in the industry so far?
You know, the sport is growing a lot has been happening, and I see a lot of new faces also. It's really something that is more interesting, that you see a lot of people involved in bodybuilding and a lot of young upcoming stars are, you know, aspiring to, you know, compete. Like I've received a lot of greetings from every one of them, looking forward to, you know, they've been looking forward to see me or meet me. They find the forum here, which is a good thing. The sport has been really growing because now we have a lot of sponsors now, you know, taking up pro shows that they are sponsoring each everywhere. So, which is things that is different from before. So we have a lot of spread around competition like this very one too, which is a good thing. People are willing to step up to do things and then make the competition look more competitive and allow a chance for people to compete. Yeah. Also, the management over the whole federation too has been, you know, very, very open in doing their own things to make sure that at least we have a chance of expressing ourselves on stage and then doing the things we do, not just training without competing. So it's a good changes that have been happening, and more better will be coming in future, what I've seen.
Yeah. Here's another question I got for you. When did you earn your IFBB Pro card? When and where?
Okay, actually, I did have my pro card in France. That was 2006. So, which I decided to, you know, come over and then compete in the United States. So it was something that I could have had it since 2004, but I was still winning all the shows over there in Europe until I got tired of it. So I said, well, I gotta go. But by the time I got my pro card, I was only weighing 189 pounds. So the fear of coming to compete with the big boys was always hindering me until one day I decided to. So
make the leap.
Yeah. And that pulled me up to, you know, seeing that they like my physique, and best of the best had been working with like Charles Glass and Flex Wheeler, Bob Chiquilelos, you know, they step in to, you know, gave me some of the good upliftment in the sport, you know, so it helped me a lot. Yeah.
What do you think about all the all these new international shows for other competitors in other countries to become professionals in their own country? For example, I know there's gonna be a Mr. Olympia in Spain for some pro or for some shows out there. They just had a Mr. Olympia in Latin America, not in February. What do you think about all these international shows for other international competitors to have a chance to compete and earn their pro card in their own country?
You know, I would rather not want to get into all those things, because the one thing is this. We have a federation, which is the IFBB Pro League, who has been running things, and there had been a chance for everybody to compete all over the world. It was the same chance that I was given even while I wasn't here in the United States to compete here. So it's a kind of a selfishness and self-ego or seeking monetary fund or kind of things that will make somebody to split out from there, because you want to have your own and then you think you are doing it for the interest of other people. But no, this chance you're giving to people was still given before, and that is the federation I am now, and that is the whole this thing. So if we really want to look into it, it's not really that it's something that is really benefiting any athlete. It only separates athletes from actually having the right future, the right things to follow. Yeah, because this federation has been giving chances to, like I said, it's been giving chances to everybody to compete. So now coming to separate them, don't allow others to compete in the one that supposed to compete. They will be doing what they are doing, but we are still in the lead on what we are doing. Yeah. So it's still IFBB Pro League. And whatever they are doing is what they are following. They see what IFBB League was doing, and that's what they are copying and doing. So
there's only one IFBB Pro?
You can't beat the best. That's one of the things. You can only want to be like the best. So athletes should be wise enough to know where they want to go and what they aspire to have in future. Exactly. So whatever pro card you're giving everywhere here is not going to be like IFBB Pro League card. Here.
Precisely. Thank you again very much for your time. I know you got to go carb up and get ready for the show tomorrow. And again, I'm truly honored to be here and the presence of you. I still have to go upstairs and get my magazine, because I have a magazine with him in it, and I've been babying that thing for years. So again, thank you very much for your time, and I'll let you get going. Thank you. And that's it for MD